Welcome to Sunday with Ola 92, everyone. Okay, so you might wonder, why the hell are you going from a left-handed guitar to a right-handed guitar? Well, the thing is that we just released this. It's a left-handed A1.6D Plus. So it has Plus pickups on it. And I intended to write a song and be able to play it all the way through on the left-handed guitar, but you know what? It's just not gonna happen. So, you know, I made that really easy, simple going OPF beginning right there. I could play that chord, you know, but you know, for the trickier stuff, I had to go with a regular right-handed guitar. How about that? So there you go. Look at this. Left-handed, right-handed. There you go. Left-handed, right-handed. There you go. Left-handed, right-handed. Left-handed, right-handed. Left-handed, right-handed. There you go. Okay. Also, something I tried out for this particular Swola right here, that Swola Riff Challenge. You know, Sunday with Swola Riff Challenge, you can be a part of it. And live stream tomorrow, Monday, okay? No, but something I did try in this Sunday with Swola is TuneTrack's Easy Bass. I got a recommendation on my Discord server that I should give it a shot. So I did, and this was Easy Bass right there in that intro. It was $150, man. But I thought it sounded pretty good. All right, it's Sunday, we're in the premiere, it's chatting time, but it's also news time. And this week's news is that Ozzy Osbourne has released a single, Patient Number 9. Look. But Ozzy is such a treasure, man, and I think when Ozzy passes away, God forbid, no negative thoughts, but when he's gonna pass, I think it's gonna be one of the toughest blows on metal in general, you know, for a very, very long time. That will shed ripples throughout the music industry, in my opinion. I mean, he's the god, man. All right, so we finally know how Tommy Lee broke his ribs. I had no idea Tommy Lee broke his ribs. Just saying. Lee broke his ribs falling down the stairs of a rental house while moving suitcases to the car. So yeah, not exactly the coolest story you've heard. Alright, so Mötley Crüe has been out on tour without Tommy, obviously, because Tommy broke his ribs falling down a set of stairs. Just, you know, that just a thing old people do. Falling down stairs, breaking ribs. Not really that rock and roll, but come on, man. I think this might be very groundbreaking news. Maybe not. KISS thanks Austrian fans with photo of the Australian flag. KISS played the venue Stadthalle in Vienna over the weekend and thanked fans for coming with a huge visual on the screen at the end of the show. The problem with the visual is whoever was in charge of making it clearly read Austria as Australia and slapped the Australian flag onto the KISS logo. Yes, look at this. I mean, geography isn't easy. And also, this guy probably googled Austria flag and it, you know, auto-corrected the Australian flag and he just took it like that. You know, geography is not easy. Just say. He was having a bad day, whoever made this. But that is funny. I just love when big acts like this pick up. Another band, by the way, that's still going out on tour. Holy shit, how old are these guys? These are f***ing dinosaur guys, man. What legends? Kerry King explains why his time in Megadeth was short-lived. I don't know how anyone can be in Megadeth longer than a few hours. Okay. I didn't know he was in Megadeth, to be honest. Seemingly off the cuff, King says about Mustaine, I don't know how anybody can be in Megadeth for more than a couple of hours. That guy's crazy. King claims that his tenure were good times, but drugs and other activities assured his time in Megadeth to be short. Okay, so this is back in the day when there was a lot of drugs and alcohol. His stuff is more, I wouldn't say intricate because we have intricate parts too, but he writes in a very different perspective, said King. Asked if the split caused a rift between King and Mustaine that evolved into a rift between Megadeth and Slayer, King confirmed it had. Yeah, I would say that's right. You can watch the full clip with King below. Okay, so at that time, maybe they weren't on good terms, but you know what? People change, people get over old quarrels and shit. Wouldn't it have been really weird if Kerry King was the lead guitar player of Megadeth? Just think about the solos, man. I don't think that would have been a good fit, but cool that they asked him. All right, I'm incredibly sorry, guys, but the news is dry as hell at the moment. I mean, it's, we're right in the like the end of June. We just started July, man. People are up to better things. They go to festivals, go to cool shows, go watch a bunch of really awesome bands. And we're sitting here at home just waiting for news like this. But there isn't none. So we're gonna check out a video of Axl Rose sounding like Family Guy's Herbert during awful festival performance. You know, I'm not one to laugh at other bands' misfortunes, except when they sing really bad. Before I start this video, Guns N' Roses have existed forever. Okay, they've been a thing since the 80s, kept on touring. I mean, what do you expect from a guy that is older and, you know, you just... Your voice is changing throughout your life, and at the end of your life, well, I'm not saying that it's end of Axl Rose's life, but the late, you know, the older you get, the more f***ed up your voice becomes. And obviously, you either have to withhold and train that voice to stay on top, or you can just let it wither. And I'm just saying, I'm just trying to be fair against people that are getting old. It's easier on guitar playing because you can, you know, obviously you're gonna get slower if you don't practice, but with vocals, it's just so... It's just so personal, you know, and your voice changing, that's a... it sucks. Anyways, let's watch the clip. Does he sound like Herbert in Family Guy? Right? Yeah, I don't think it was that bad, you know? It's just, you know, it's probably a combination of the, you know, the iPhone he's filming it with. You know, he does sound like Herbert, but that's not a laughing matter, okay? This is just how life is, man. You can't expect them to deliver the same goods as back during the 80s, man, when they were on the top of their game. I think it's really cool that they're still touring because, you know, it's a great service to the fans of the band. It's the exact same with a singer like Phil Anselmo, for instance, who basically, you know, his voice is... half shot today from you know, drugs and alcohol, singing, and also aging, obviously. And I would still want to go to see Phil Anselmo and whatever, the Legals or Down or whatever. I would still love to go and see him because I think it's a great service for the fans. I'm a big fan of Phil and Pantera. Of course I want to go see him, even if it doesn't sound as good as in his prime. Just saying. There you go. That was the news. Holy shit, that sucked ass. No memory card. I'm about fan. Apparently I didn't put a memory card in that asshole right there. I thought it was filming. So we're just going for four cameras today. No, just three. That's okay. So for today's adventure with Ola, it's very different. I've never been a part of anything like this before, but a couple of months back, I got an email from something called Min Stora Dag, which is basically a Swedish version of Make-A-Wish Foundation. Basically a foundation for kids that have a critical illness. The foundation worked to fulfill dreams of kids, basically, up to 18 years. And Min Stora Dag is basically like a Swedish variant of Make-A-Wish Foundation. And they contacted me and they said that there is a kid who had a wish to meet me. A guitar player kid that has a wish to meet me, which is f***ing insane. Who the f*** would want to meet me as a high wish, you know? Obviously, I said yes because f***ing hell, if I can make one kid's day better, easy. You know, so we've been preparing this for a couple of months, and last week Oliver came to the office. He got to meet me. We did a bunch of stuff. He played some guitar. At first I didn't plan to make a video of this because this is about, you know, this kid and his day, but it seemed that Oliver wanted to be in a video, so we decided to make a short little Adventures with Ola when Oliver arrived here. So here it goes. It's in Swedish, but you know, I'll put some subtitles there. Okay, so here you go. Go. Fuck, this is far. So here you go.
Ja, precis. Liksom det här, så det här är vårt lager och våra...
Trösterar
nu, ja. Ja. Vi trycker tröjor, vi trycker koppar, vi trycker...
Nej, det är det. Som säljer tröjorna. någonstans
och så ska de... Så här på den väggen har jag, det är solargitarr, tror jag, det mesta. Och så på den här väggen liksom lite mer, det här är mina fingitarrer, så att säga. De får du jättegärna testa också såklart.
Jag vågar inte.
Ja men det är okej, det ska vi fixa, det måste du göra. Så att jag har ju lite olika mina hjältar då, som jag har i de här då. Då är det Pantera då, och Dimebag, det är en gitarrist. Det var min stora hjälte. Elvin Halen där. Sen är en till, John Petrucci, spelar ett band som heter Dream Theater.
Ja,
han har väl en...
Jag har en Majesty.
Ja, okej, ja.
Vad heter det? John Petrucci, Sterling,
ja,
The Music Man.
Just det.
Ice Cream So Red.
Ja, skitfränt. Men, och så Steve Vai här då.
Ja.
Så att här är, det här är liksom, när jag sitter och pratar, då är det ju här.
Ja.
Så att, så jag har ingen söndagsshow, då sitter jag här liksom. Så skriver jag musik, då sitter jag här. Producerar jag, sitter här. Editerar jag, sitter här. Det är ju så när man är i den här branschen, då måste man göra väldigt mycket.
Mm.
För att kunna gå runt.
Just det.
Så man måste göra allt. Det är därför vi har valt att trycka t-shirts, för att då behåller vi kontroll och vi gör det själva. Och bara ta bort lite mellanhänder.
Mm.
Så här, slå dig ner. En gamingstol från 2010 eller något sånt där. Jag valde att köpa en så stor som möjligt, för att det här när man spelar gitarr så får man inte plats i stolarna. Så att man liksom, för om man kollar så här, om du sitter så där, så sätter man gitarr.
Du skojar med mig.
Så liksom, då slår man inte i.
Ja, för det där vet jag att
jag vågar inte spela.
Jag spelar här.
Nej, för helvete.
Ja, men så att det är jätteviktigt.
Jag gör det nu.
Det är klart att du ska spela, du får passa på.
Gör det nu när du är här. Kör på bara.
Nej, vänta, nu ska jag fixa ett schysst ljud.
Vad är för program var det så?
Just det här är, det är som en virtuell förstärkare, och det är ju väldigt vanligt nu för tiden. Man har inte de här längre,
nej.
Riktigt, utan det här är ju det folk är vana vid idag. Det här är jättebra för när man ska sitta och skriva och bara få lite feeling, men ska man spela liksom med band, då måste man...
Ja.
Det är lite läskigt att hålla i din gitarr.
Grymt.
Och ljudet är ju fantastiskt. Vad i helvete.
En bra reklam det.
Ja, en bra reklam. Ska vi, fan jag tänkte, ska vi ta och slänga upp en stärka eller? Bara kör lite på riktigt liksom. Det här är ju kul, men liksom fan kör på riktigt stärkare. Det är klart vi ska göra det.
Nu gör vi det tillsammans.
Ja, absolut, absolut, det fixar vi.
Jag vågar inte.
Så spelar du också gitarr?
Lite.
Ja, men här.
Nej.
Känner du att det är något du vill prova? Peka, så bara kör vi ut det sen. Den där, bra val.
Alltid. Jag har en fråga till dig.
Ja.
Vad är din favoritlåt någonsin? Du får välja en.
Det måste bli en Pantera-låt i så fall. Mm. Om jag måste välja en. Och då är det nog... Oj. Jag tror Cemetery Gates ligger högt upp.
Unbroken tycker jag.
Ja, det är rätt bra. Det är min favoritskiva för övrigt. Det
känns bara rätt att spela liksom en Van Halen-låt på.
Ja, det är precis. Men ska jag... Det är Van Halen-gitarr. Så här känns det av gitarrtech. Någon som sätter gitarrerna i ens knä. We're gonna have a surprise and we'll get it. Det är eftersom du har satt och spelat en skivsträng. Du ska testa den här. Den här är helt ny. Och stämt. Vänta, du är bättre att du öppnar den. Jag tar den här. Sådär. Såg du den där? Det är en riktig sjusträngen.
Jo.
Det som är bra med den här, det är lite kortare skala på den här också. Yeah. Snyggt. Du gör den rätt också, precis som där.
Ja.
Hur känns den här gitarren då?
Jävligt skönt.
Vilken tur, för den är din.
Va?
Min stora dag har fixat och köpt dig gitarr åt dig.
Va? Du skojar med mig.
Nej.
Oj! Okej.
Så där är helt din. Där får du förstöra hur mycket du vill.
Okej. Okay. Den kommer... Jag vet inte... Jag, va?
Åh, fy fan.
Men rock and roll på riktigt, va?
Kan det bli bättre?
Ja. Nej.
Det kan bli lite bättre om du vill.
Det kan bli lite bättre om du vill.
Jag ska göra. Ja.
Sen är den viktiga frågan. Vill du att jag ska signa den där?
Ja.
Okej. Okay. Mm. Sådär. Så kör jag på baksidan också, för man vet ju aldrig.
Ja, man vet aldrig.
Och så gillar du inte, kan du sälja den, får säkert jättebra pris för den. Eftersom, eller mindre, eftersom jag signat den. Det vet man inte heller.
Helvete, tack som in och helvete. Ja, förlåt.
Helt taget.
Jag vet inte vad jag ska säga.
Nej, jag vill inte säga något.
Du behöver inte säga någonting.
Nej, jag vågar inte.
Du får spela på den hemma,
Henrik. Du får spela på den hemma.
Jo.
Det som är skönt är att när du tar fram den hemma, då kommer den vara sådär. Men vet du, om du vill, vill du att den ska vara i dropp, så kan jag fixa det, så att den är det till så att du... Nej, men för då hinner jag, då kan jag och Joel fixa gitarren. Och så liksom så att den är helt perfekt, så du bara kan gå in och rocka med bandet sen.
Ja, gärna.
Följ med ut då, så ser jag om
du
kan trycka.
Är du helt darrig, Oliver?
Ja, jag är lite darrig.
Jag ser det på dig.
Jo, jag trycker lite t-shirts.
Ja, två. Jag vill hälsa den här
då. Och så fast den är helt lag.
Holy shit, man. What a legend. Oliver, everyone. What an absolute legend, and holy shit, that was a lot of fun. He came here, he got to print t-shirts and get some merch and all that, he got his guitar, he had a good day, we had lunch, it was excellent. And also, I didn't expect this, but it really became emotional for me as well, because as he was here and I saw him, you know, I saw his love for guitar playing, you know, that young kid, 16 years old, you know, playing guitar, he was just... You know, getting to play all these guitars that I take for granted because, you know, these are my guitars. But, you know, putting guitars in his hands and he'd be like, he would shine up and, you know, play his riffs and songs. You know, I saw how much that made him happy. And it's easy to forget about that. The simpler things, man. And that hunger for guitar playing when you were a teenager and all of this was new to you. And that made me just incredibly happy to see and really inspired me. And, you know, do not take things for granted, man. Life is short, baby. Thank you so much, Oliver, for visiting us. And hope you like that Adventures with Ola. Unboxing with Ola. How long ago was this? I don't know, but I got a box from who? From M. Wilkins. Okay, let's go. I'm just trying to not show my address to everyone. People love unboxing videos. Why is that? I enjoy them too. But it's more fun when you're the guy opening them. Just saying. Shit, what's this? Good things come in small packages. Tell me about it. Damn. So it says one on this one, two on that one. Okay, let's open it up. Oh shit, what is this? The dick pic. Send your friend a dick pic. What the hell? Alright, look, it's a set of balls right there. What the hell? What is this? Ola's dick pic, okay. Is this my penis? Oh shit, oh look at that. It's a dick pic. How clever. So it's basically a wooden pic with a dick on it. That's just lovely, wow, thank you so much. What's in box number two? Oh shit, okay, cool man. Look at that, he made me coasters, what a legend. And what is this? Some guitar picks. A little keychain dick. How about that? Ola's ball sack. Oh damn, look at this. Wow, look at this little box right here I made. F***ing hell. Another dick pic, hello! That's the best type of dick pic I've ever had. Wow, shit. So I guess, instead of making the unsolicited dick picture that you shouldn't be doing, I'm talking to you guys, okay? You can now send a dick pic to someone... someone. Great. You know what? This is actually the first time I've ever been sent a dick pic. But it made me really happy. Thank you so much. Boys and girls, this has been Sunday with Ola 92. Hope you had an excellent time. I just have to explain the fan. It's because it's really fucking hot, okay? It's really fucking hot in Sweden. I mean, for us, when it's 32 degrees outside, we're not built for that shit. I mean, the houses are fucking built to keep heat inside. Basically, our houses become saunas here in Sweden. It's terrible. And now I just realized I've become a complaining YouTuber. I hate that. So guys, I want to say thank you so much for watching this video. If you want to be a part of Sunday with Ola Riff Challenge, you download the drums in the description of this video. To everyone that has been chatting in the premiere, thank you so much. You guys are amazing. Hope you have a great Sunday. I'll see you next week, okay? Goodbye.